Page 46, 1. It's the last piece of the book. This is a little fun piece, just a short little piece. It's got staccato all over the place. So obviously there's no pedal in this. It's just staccato here and there and some legato, and try and mix the staccato and legato together and okay. I have a few things I'd like to point out, a few tricky things, and then some fingering suggestions. I'm going to start with the right hand, as usual. Now take a look at measure 10 on page 46. It's the first measure of the fourth line. It has a 10 with a box. That's the measure numbers at the beginning of each line, so you can figure out what the measures are. The fingering in the right hand, you're starting out with fifth finger on the A. For the last two notes, the F sharp A, I recommend a 2-4. Because that puts you in position for the next chord. And we like to, or I like to, feel the melody. I like to make the melody more or less legato, or at least so it could be legato if I wanted it to be. I want to. That's the melody, and that's why I finger it in such a way that I can connect the notes. I'll measure 11. The first chord is 1-3-5. Top note is the melody. With the next chord, I recommend a 1-2-4, so I can connect the melody note. And then for the last measure of that line, a 1-3. Take a look at measure 14. We have B natural to a G sharp, F sharp, F natural, F sharp to a G sharp. Yeah, that last note is still a G sharp, because that sharp from before, you know, in the measure still applies. And then the next measure is connect the melody note. And then for measure 16 at the top of page 47, I recommend a 1-4, because I want to connect the melody, and I can go over the fifth finger and reach it with the fourth without a lot of problem. This is quite common in piano playing, and I recommend you learn to do it. That sets you up for the last. Now, they don't have any phrasing marked in here to speak of, so follow the words with the phrasing. When you finish a sentence, you finish a phrase. Measure 16 finishes a sentence. It's got a period after it. Measure 17 starts a new sentence. So don't connect the C sharp with the D. Just lift the hand up and drop it. So you're finishing this phrase and start a new one. As a little bit of silence in the right hand between those two notes. Go to the bottom of page 47. Let's just do the whole line in the right hand. I'm going to start with measure 29. You have the F, A, E flat. The E flat, bring out the E flat, that's the melody. For the next measure, I recommend a 1-2-4. Because the D is melody, and I want to connect the E flat and the D. And then the next measure, 1-2-5. And then you have a quarter rest to get your hand down to there, in that position. Left hand has staccatos pretty much throughout, not totally, but almost. So you nice little light wrist staccato on here should be fine. Just do what they're telling you to do. I want to point out at the bottom of page 46, it's the last measure on the page. The first chord is a C sharp A. The second one is a C sharp G sharp, but I recommend a 5-2. And then on measure 16, the next measure, the first measure, 47, page 47, it's here. The half note isn't staccato, those are the notes. So make sure it's, you know, it's an accented half note, so it's just a. On measure 17, at the top of page 47, you have the. But there's a decrescendo there. So each of these chords should get a little bit softer, so you're. So you're dying away. Now there's not a lot of difference between forte and mezzo forte. So in measure 17, it starts out forte, and then you have a decrescendo to measure 18, which is mezzo forte, which is just a little bit softer. I recommend when you decrescendo, you go down almost to soft, and then come back at the next measure at a mezzo forte. We exaggerate that decrescendo, in other words, to bring it out a little more, so it's... And then the next measure, it's back up to mezzo forte. So on measure 17, the first chord is forte. The next one can be forte 2. Next one's a little bit softer. Next one's a little bit softer. And then you get into the next measure, go back up to mezzo forte. However loud that is, you'll have to decide how loud these things really are, but that's what I'm suggesting. Measure 23, you have a quarter note staccato, followed by a dotted half note, and that is three counts. Make sure you hold that down full three counts to the next measure. So it's one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Don't cut it short. The bottom of the page, 47, the last two measures, the fingering, look at the fingering. You have a B flat, B, C, crossover for the D flat, C, B, and a B flat. That's a good fingering, and it's common. And then you're dropping down in the last measure. Let's talk about these triplets. You get them in both hands. And hopefully they're not too much of a trouble for you. You're counting 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't really have any straight eighth notes. You don't have any 1 and 2, and there's no eighth notes in there for it. They've actually written out the dotted rhythms. 1, ba-bum, ba-bum. Well, look at measure 4, for instance. Those are triplets, so we're going to go 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 1, 2. Put just a little bit of accent, just a hair accent at the beginning of each triplet. I exaggerated that, but that's what I'm trying to get across. Feel it. In either hand. Just a little bit of an accent at the beginning of each triplet. It does a whole lot to the musicality of the piece. Anyway, let's try this out and see what happens. We're going to go slow. You can speed it up. I'm sure there's recordings of this. And if you were singing it, how fast would you sing it? So you decide how fast you want to go, but we're going to go slow. I'll give us four counts and we'll play this together. So put your hands where they go. All right. 1, 2, ready, go.
Three, four, one, two, three, four.